Hey everybody, it's Nitro99 again, doing a new Ninjago double review on the Kai Fighter, which is 196 pieces and 2 minifigures, which cost $20 to $25, and also on the Thunder Raider, which is 334 pieces, and it comes with 3 new minifigures, and that costs like $35 to $40, in Canada it's $40. But these are brand new, well for Canada they are, and it's the new Ninjago season, this one time of robots. Of course, everybody always knew that Zane was a robot, and then he's pictured up here. The box is really, really fresh and, like, new-looking. It just looks really clean and nice colors. Little cyborg. There's an evil robot back there, a Nindroid. And this set, the Thunder Raider, comes with the Nindroid, Jay, Cole, and that's it. And they also have new weapons. As you can see, the Nindroid has a double lightsaber, which is definitely a lightsaber. And also they have these new energy weapons, kind of like Bionicle. And finally, this cool set is really cool because it's like a half-track tank, but you can also put the robot mecha on the back of the half-track tank thing. And of course, there's 3 of these weapons. Ninjago's always had collectible weapons, and this is the 3rd one. And you also get another one in the Kai Fighter. So here's the Kai Fighter. It's interesting that Kai is now has the jet before, and also made a review on it. You can check it out. There, it was Jay's fighter, and now Kai is a fighter. So now, if you still have the Jay fighter, you could probably have a fight with both. But mine is not built. And interesting, it says this one has actually number 4, and on that box it only had 3 shown, and this one has 4 shown. So, maybe that's a. Oh, never mind. It actually does have 4, but it was so tiny I didn't see it. That's my fault. But this is a pretty cool set too. It's only $25 in Canada, and probably $20 in the United States. And let's start off reviewing this, Kai Fighter. Also the manuals, they have a Technic feel. It's a lot more adult. It's interesting, I guess it's almost growing with the age group that would play Ninjago from a few years ago. These colors just look more adult and like modern, and it's a lot different, but it's a good different. Let's start with the figures. You first get General Cryptor. He's one of the bad guys in this new Ninjago series. For some reason, Sensei Wu has turned evil, and he's the main baddie. But General Cryptor has a very interesting weapon. It's like a giant RPG, and he holds it from there. It doesn't seem like to be heavy at all, but of course he's a robot. But as you can also see, they have these new masks, which are very, very interesting. See there. They look really cool too, to be honest. And they cover up one side of the eye, and it has 3 little dots on it, kind of like Predator. You probably won't be able to, you can focus, just like in Predator, you know, the movie with Arnold Schwarzenegger. And here is General Cryptor's face. He looks like he's kind of angry, but also happy. It's interesting. And, I just ripped General Cryptor in half. And in the back, he has this armor. Very similar to the Ninjago armor from before, which was golden and had a sword sheath in the back. But here's his torso. It looks like it's the same as the other Nindroid. Almost the same. Almost the same. Not quite. As you can see, here's the other Nindroid. And you can see the sash is different. But I'll get to him in a second. So that's General Cryptor. Next you have Kai. And the reason this set is really good to get Kai, because finally they're including the hair of the ninjas. You always saw the hair in the TV show, but finally you can get the hair yourself. And of course he has this battle axe energy weapon, which is very interesting looking. And he has a sword, of course, a katana. And here is his torso. He looks really cool. He has a mask. All the ninjas have masks now. And that's a new accessory, which is actually a new design all completely and a new piece. And you also get an extra mask in case you lose this one or in case you want to put it on a different figure. And his hair is rubbery. It's a brand new kind of design. They have focus there. Wow, he just doesn't want to focus this time. Oh, silly. Silly guy. Oh, there he focuses. And it's dark brown. Hair is really nice. It's probably the best thing in this set. Probably in my opinion. Oh, I'm sorry about that. Because it's just, you can't get that hair anywhere else, and it's very interesting. It's really a unique style, and it has a lot of mocking potential. But here is the jet, as you can see here. It doesn't really do much except this, and this is very interesting that it does this. I'm not sure why. It's definitely a Power Ranger vehicle. This is definitely out of the Power Rangers. Lego totally ripped them off. But except for this, I'm not sure what this is even for. It doesn't have any flip-fire missiles, which is a good thing in my opinion, but it also doesn't do much else. It has these swords in the front, which are pretty cool for stabbing and fighting. It has two, oh, it does have flip-fire missiles. Right here. I didn't even see them. Sometimes Lego puts them in plain sight to trick me. And also has these little flaps here, which have stickers of fire on it. And has TS70721 for some reason. And some vents, which is just detailing for stickers. The cockpit opens, Kai can fit in there. There's nothing else, there's no controls or anything. And that's pretty much it. It's actually a very nice looking jet. It doesn't really make a whole lot of sense aerodynamic wise, but that doesn't really matter. It's a toy, and it looks cool. Okay, I'm going to review the Thunder Raider now. It's this set over here, even though I haven't switched. And the first minifigure is a Nindroid. He is a little bit different from the General Cryptor in the fact that he has a sash. It's much bigger. You can see here. Hopefully General Cryptor cooperates. I dropped General Cryptor because he doesn't want to cooperate with me. See, it's a little bit different. Very similar, but a little bit different. Just that big sash. That's the only thing. The face is also different, but that's just another minor thing. General Cryptor has a metal mask on. It looks a little bit cooler. This guy looks more serious, though. Next, we have Jay, one of the ninjas. It's kind of disappointing they don't have their backpacks anymore. I mean, the armored pauldrons with sword carriers. But now they have these masks, which looks pretty nice. He comes with a golden katana. And very cool looking torso. It definitely that Cthulhu lightning god in the back is really funny. I don't think they ever really... the first series they had the dragons, elemental dragons, but they didn't really explain what the symbols mean. Always wonder that. So there's Jay's face, and that's Jay. Cole, on the other hand, I'll get to him in a second. I guess I should do this first. This is a little turret with the energy axe. I'm not sure what these are called. And this is used by the Nindroid. He can also take these off and hold them. They're lightsabers, obviously. Lightsabers. And he has two of those. And they're also fires lasers, so he's actually well-equipped. However, he's not really well-equipped to deal with a half-track tank with a robot on the back, which is what this thing is, the Thunder Raider. As you can see, it looks really intimidating, and it's pretty cool looking. It's well built, too. But the main thing, and I didn't even know about this toy off the back of the manual, is the fact you take this off, and you have the mech. The little, Cole's little mech. And interesting that it just, very interesting. It's very simple, but it just works with the set. And it's a good little addition. Here he has some stickers. I'm not sure what they say, but there's number 5. I don't know why. Why is there's a number 5 there? No idea. And back here he has that his little Earth symbol, which is like I guess the Earth dragon. I guess that's supposed to, they're supposed to be, but I'm not sure. And this little symbol, I'm not sure what that is either. And here is Cole. Cole is of course one of the coolest ninjas because he's black. I mean, he wears the typical black ninja garb, which really looks nice, especially now. The fact that they continue to update the outfits is nice. They don't keep the outfits the same. And also, you get Cole's hair now, which is the Justin Bieber hair, except it's in black. And it's also emo hair. And, of course, you get the black mask. Interesting, I didn't actually get an extra black mask. I got an extra one for Jay. However, I didn't get one for Cole. I'm not sure why that is. I have to ask, did anyone else get extra masks or not? Because I certainly did not. Anyway, there's Cole. Very cool. One of my favorite ninjas. The mech is very simple, but straightforward and nice. I can't say anything bad about it. Even has a Hero Factory pauldron plate thing there. swords and cannons for shooting out rocks or energy blasts. And finally, we have the Thunder Raider, which looks very sick. And it does this. It just pops out. You just put the cockpit back, and you get these missiles, which for some reason, I don't have the missiles things on there. I don't know why that is. But, yeah, missiles. They're not really flick fire. There's actually no flick fire missiles on this, which is very interesting, because LEGO just loves flick fire missiles. And it has the tracks, which are really nice. And the wheels are big and hollow, and this is a very nice set. There is actually detail in the cockpit this time. As you can see there. And lightning sticker and two more katanas. And overall, I like this set. I like this set more. Maybe it's because it's more expensive and is thus better because it has more pieces and stuff to do, but I think the addition to the fact that they have two actual character sets in one plus an enemy makes it better than Kai's fighter. Even though I do like the how Kai's fighter looks. It'd be cool if they could actually had, like back in the day, they had manuals and they actually had like double builds. We could actually build this and put this together with this one to build something better, like definitely like Power Rangers. But they don't do that. I guess it's up to your imagination. However, in my opinion, Thunder Raider is nicer. I want to know your opinion though. And I guess my opinion was prejudiced because it's a bigger set, but I actually like that. If this thing was by itself, I would like it more than the jet, even though the jet's really cool. So, that's my review on Thunder Raider and Kai Fighter. Hope you enjoyed it. And also review on the big Ninjroid Dragon coming soon for Ninjago. And also Back to the Future set. And also other things like movie reviews. So, stay tuned. Press like, favorite, and subscribe, of course. See you later. Bye.